Hello everyone, welcome back to another painting time-lapse video. Today we'll be painting the lovely Labradoodle puppy by the name of Winston. As you can see from the title, I'll be going over the details of the techniques on how to paint a black dog with curly hair and how to achieve those forms and that nice wavy locks look. If you want to check out my previous video of painting a black Pomeranian puppy, I'll link that in the description box below. And if this is your very first time on this channel, we post videos of mostly painting time-lapse, art topics, art videos, as well as tarot card related and tarot readings on this channel. I'll eventually be designing my own tarot deck, so you'll get to watch my whole journey of creating that down the road here on this channel and enjoy some free readings along the way. So for those that watched my previous videos, I mentioned that I always paint from background to foreground because it's just easier to me. So I started with the background and you can see I already completed the eyes because the eyes were all the way the back, all the fur, the nose was closer to the camera and it was nice. It was a part of the background to me. Like it was just so far back in the painting and there's everything else that's overlaying on top. And with the eyes, they are so simple. Don't overcomplicate it. Use your reference photo. Copy exactly what you see in your reference photo. Paint what you see. Start with the color of the eyes and build up the details on top. Again, with this painting, I had two different tones of black just to make the painting come alive more. Instead of just having flat black all the way through, you'll notice that, for example, on one side of the dog, it is more of warmer tones, more yellows in both the whites and the blacks, and on the other side of the dog, it's cooler tones to capture that shadow side of the puppy. And it's really obvious here in the ear. I went a little crazy with the warm tones. It literally looks like it's an orange ear over there. With curly hair, it's so simple. It's simpler than I thought, actually. It's literally three steps. And I did these three steps over and over again for this painting. First step, put in the base color, just slap it on, block it in, and then you add in the details, which are the lights and the shadows. So step one, block in base color. Second, add in the lights, where the light is hitting, the highlights. And number three, add in the shadows. And it's working these three steps over and over again until you achieve the look that you're creating, that you're wanting to achieve, I mean. And another thing you want to ask yourself when you're creating a painting, what do you want the viewer to focus on? So in this case, with pet portraits, you want the viewer to focus on the face. So you add more details in, especially the eyes, with like a really tiny brush. Add in those details with the eyes, the nose, the face, so that the viewer's eyes are drawn to those elements. And with the other parts of the paintings, you want to make those less detailed, so it's almost like a blurred situation. In the foot of this painting, his paws and his chest, the paws are super undetailed, you'll see. And the chest, it's more detailed because it's closer to the face. And when it came to the face, I put the most time, energy, and effort into because I really wanted to add those very intricate shadows and lights to create the detail that I was looking to achieve so that it's the most interesting part of the painting. And when it comes to the shadows, the lights, and how you want those curls to appear, you want to look mainly at the shadows and ask yourself, what shape is this shadow creating? And you want to imitate and copy that shadow the best of your abilities and create that shape instead of just making line after line, strand after strand. No, it's with hair, with fur, you want to ask yourself, what shape is that highlight creating? And what shape is that ball of fur over here creating? And what shape is that shadow creating? And you want to create that shape. And by doing that over and over again, adding the details, the layers, the lights and the shadows, you'll be able to achieve that realistic look. I had so much fun painting Winston and Charlie. Again, if you want to check out Charlie the Pomeranian, which I also painted, that is in the description box below. For the Marvel fans, I also painted Venom a week or two ago, and that is also linked in the description box below. That is really cool to watch the painting come alive. If you enjoyed watching this painting time lapse as much as I loved painting Winston, please give it a giant thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel. We have a good time all the time, tarot and chilling and painting and talking about art and life. Otherwise, I will see you in another video. Bye for now.